Hello everybody and welcome to Morzak EV, a channel dedicated to all things electric vehicles, electric vehicle charging and all related technologies. So today I want to explain to you why I think you should get one of these instead of using one of these. So I'm hoping you are all familiar with one of these, which is your smart meter home display. You can't really see it because it's a beautifully sunny day at the moment. But yeah, this is a smart meter home display that gives you information on your energy usage. It'll tell you how much you've spent today, what your live usage is, and it's generally a good indicator of you know, when you put devices on that use a lot of electricity, like a kettle, this will tell you that your energy usage is increasing, and it kind of acts as a warning, if you like. Octopus are running a beta trial with these, and if you're an Octopus customer, you can apply for one of these, and it's called the Octopus Home Mini. So this sort of does what this does, but I think it's much better. So I'm going to explain to you why I think if you are an Octopus customer, you should get one of these. So when we applied for one of these, it arrived in the post about 4 weeks later. We were put on a waiting list. It's super simple to set up, so I'm not going to go through the setup process. All the instructions are there. You get the mini, you get a charge lead and a 3-pin plug, or you can just plug it into any USB port if you want to charge it off a run it off a USB port. Super simple to connect to your account. There's a couple of videos which I'll link in the description which talk you through the setup process. So once it's set up, you start getting live data onto your Octopus usage on your app. So the first reason why I think you should buy one of these, it's free. End of video. If you don't have one of these, your data tends to be around 24 hours old. So basically, your smart meter collects all the data and then it gets uploaded once per day. So you'll be able to look at yesterday's usage, but not today's usage. One of these gives you your latest energy usage, tells you how much you've used for the full day, and you can look at your weekly usage, go through the stats, but this is quite lacking in detail, whereas this it has a lot more information. So if I shuffle over here, I'll put up my phone screen on the left here, and you can see an example of what you see when you go into the app. You go into the app, goes to usage, and it starts showing you. You can look at your last 5 minutes live usage, or you can look at your last 30 minutes live usage. And this updates about every 10 seconds. So it's brilliant. At the moment, you see the graphs I'm showing you, I'm actually showing zero usage. That's because we've got ton of solar at the moment, we've got our battery system running, so we're expecting aggregate usage to be zero throughout the day. What I'll do is I'll turn the solar and battery off later, get some graphs of what that looks like and show you that here, and you can see updating every 10 seconds showing you what your current usage is when you know your baseline usage for the house. So what I want to talk about is why is that useful? Why is it more useful than this? If you're looking to reduce your energy usage, either because you want to save money, which is a really good idea, or save energy and help save the planet, that's an even better idea. With the Octopus Home Mini, you can start conducting experiments in your house as to what devices use what energy. So if you haven't got home storage battery, or you don't have something like a My Energies app, you don't have any access to the real-time data outside of this. And this is, it's pretty vague at best. Whereas with this, you can say turn on something like the iron, like your washing machine, like your tumble dryer, and in real time track how much energy that's using. Things like your oven, you can get good detail of, if I do the cooking of 20 minutes and I put my hob on or put my oven on, how much electricity does that use? And you can look at that every 10 seconds and see, oh well, actually it looks like it uses a lot of electric when I first turn it on, but then the thermostats kick in and maybe some things might use less energy than you thought, and that allows you to focus on what's important, what should I be running at night if I can, or when the grid is at its greenest and when electricity is at its cheapest. So it allows you to conduct that sort of conduct those sort of experiments. Another great usage for this is if you're doing the energy saving events that Octopus run. If you wanted to take part in those, you can use your Octopus Home Mini when that time ticks over to start turning things off and seeing exactly how much impact that's having on your bill. Again, you can track it as you turn things off, see your energy usage plummeting, so you can get those savings and achieve your target for the energy saving event, and then get that the credits back or the money back that you want. Just have a sip of my margarita. It's just lemonade. So we obviously have a ton of solar and we have batteries installed. Obviously, if you don't have solar and you don't have battery storage, this is the perfect way to start collecting data on what energy you're using and when you're using it. And you do this in two ways. So first, you don't necessarily need the Home Mini to collect that data, but it is a good way of sort of in real time start assessing where what you energy you're using and when. So one of the things we really struggle with when we're quoting a solar and battery system, we can look at we very often get a bill showing somebody's 12 months of usage, for example. What's really difficult is to tell when that energy is being used, because depending on when that energy is being used might determine if you need a battery system at all. So, for example, if your heaviest usage is in the daytime when your solar would be generating anyway, and then you're very light user at night, maybe people work afternoon shifts in the house, then maybe a battery system isn't necessarily going to benefit you as much as other people. Another good example is looking at what devices you might be running. Maybe you're running them in the daytime, but then getting an understanding of, well, actually, our washing machine, we can set on a timer and run that at night. That shifts it outside of the daytime usage, and therefore, you don't want to take those devices into account when you calculate the battery capacity. So between something like this and the energy data that you can download from your Octopus account, which I'll take you through in a minute, we can gain a much better understanding of how much energy you're using, but more importantly, when you're using it, and that will enable us to calculate the size of the system that you want or that's going to be more cost effective for you to be installed and what you can make the most of. Because there's no point in installing 20 kilowatt hours of batteries if your daytime usage, i.e. your off-peak times when energy is more expensive, is going to be, you know, at most 5 kilowatt hours a day. So it's really important to get those battery sizings correct. Otherwise, you're just wasting money that you'll never get back. And your investment in your solar and battery system stops being a good investment. The second point I wanted to go through was downloading the data. Now again, you can download that the data on your Octopus Energy account. You don't need the Home Mini. But if you want to download your half hourly reading data, I'll show you how to do that. So you go into your Octopus account, go into Explore My Usage, and then it's got this nice little button here where you can get your geek on and start exploring your data. So you can put in as large a date range as you want. The bigger the date range, I found, the longer it takes to process and download the data. But yeah, so if you want to look at, say, your last week's worth of data, I'll do that in here. Put the date in, and then when you click download, because it's only a week, downloads fairly quickly, downloads as a CSV file, so you can open it in something like Excel. You get these half hourly plots. Now, if somebody like ourselves comes to you and asks for your data, this is the best way to provide the data to a solar PV and battery installer to give them the best idea of what energy has been used and when. And then we can use Excel to create a nice graph of how much energy, what's the peak energy usage, and when it's being used. So I hope that was useful. I hope you understand why I think this is better than this. I think the main thing is this gives you a much better understanding. I'll also put a link to EV Nick's interview with one of the Octopus guys who's been involved in the development of this, and that kind of gives you an idea of the future roadmap and the possibilities with this. But I think something like this, we're only just sort of scratching the surface at the moment, and the more data we have access to, the better we can understand when people are using their electricity, how much they're using, and make improvements to our energy infrastructure. So it can only be a good thing. So yeah, definitely check it out. So I wonder, have any of you guys got one of these already? What do you think of it? Has it proven useful? Maybe it hasn't. Yeah, make sure you leave us a comment on your experience of the Octopus Home Mini. I found it really easy to set up as well, but maybe some people have had issues, I don't know. So let us know in the comments below. Make sure you give us a cheeky thumbs up on that like button if you like the video. It really does help the channel. Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon if you want notifications of our future videos on electric vehicles, electric vehicle charging, solar PV, battery storage. And in the meantime, thanks very much for watching.